Namaste, everyone, and welcome to another session of morning yoga. My name is Emily, and I'm here with Leisure Room Productions and Miss Rosie. And we are going to take you through this morning practice where we open the body, get the heart and the mind into a space of alignment, to a space of feeling, releasing, so that we may better orient to our day, unlock a potential of creativity that exists inside all of us. We can soothe the mind and the heart, bring us towards a space where we are able to communicate through a frequency of love. So if you're joining me today, feel free to roll out your mat and grab your props and your practice aids, and we'll get started. So like always, we're gonna start in a nice seated position. Go ahead and find your way there. Make sure you feel really rooted and grounded in your space. Finding a cross-legged position, or maybe kneeling, or even perhaps coming into a half or a full lotus if it feels comfortable for you. Just remembering that the joints are just waking up this morning. So we want to be nice and gentle as we open the body, kind to ourselves. So let's just let the eyes come closed if it feels comfortable for you. Take a deep breath in through the nose, acknowledging your presence here in this space, following that breath in. And as you exhale, begin to relax the shoulders away from the ears. At the same time, extending the spine nice and tall and putting a gentle tuck in the chin to elongate the back of the neck. Perhaps bringing the hands to the tops of the knees. Continuing with your breath, breathing in through the nose. And as we move along here, gently bringing the tip of your tongue to the roof of your mouth and exhaling through the nose. Here we invite our Ujjayi Pranayama into this practice. Our victorious breath, our oceanic breath. The breath that helps to build fire, Agni, into the soul. That fire of determination, of resiliency, that allows us to shine a light on those areas of our existence that need our attention, that need our energy, our love, our compassion. And it's in this space of recognizing our breath and the connection it has with our existence that we take the moment to set an intention for this practice. Finding that space inside yourself in which you can focus this breath. Maybe that intention is towards healing, maybe towards compassion, maybe towards acceptance, maybe towards forgiveness. Whatever the intention is that you're setting for yourself today, bring it into your heart. Breathe life into that intention. Each breath creating a little bit more space for what this intention holds and significance to our lives. On the next inhale, let's sweep the arms up towards the sky. And as you exhale, hands to heart center, breathe it out. On your next inhale, let's place the right hand on top of the left knee and the left hand behind us, sitting tall on the inhale. And exhale as we twist through the soft belly on the exhale. Take one more deep breath in here. Sitting just a bit taller. Exhale, twisting just a bit deeper. Inhale, come back to center. On your exhale, placing the left hand on top of the right knee, setting the right hand behind you and inhaling to sit tall. And exhaling to twist through the soft belly, taking the gaze over the right shoulder. Deep breaths in, deep breaths out. Inhale, coming back to center. And as you exhale, we'll fold over our bent legs, walking the fingertips forward, bringing the forehead and the chest closer to the earth. One more breath here. Inhale as you start to walk the fingertips back up. And we'll transition here now onto our hands and knees. Waking up the pup, asking for my mat back. Coming onto the hands and knees here, we'll make sure the shoulders are right above the wrists and the hips right above the knees, that our toes are untucked and our shins are pressing down into the mat. On your next inhale, let's lift the chin, let the belly drop, splay through the tailbone, curve through the back. As you exhale, tuck through the chin, round through the shoulders, pull the belly button up to the spine as you press the hips forward. Inhale into your cow pose. Exhale into your cat pose. Inhale into your cow pose. Exhale into your cat pose. feeling the breath move along the spine, through the belly, in and out through the nose. Noticing any sensations that are arising. Noticing how the body feels. Noticing any of the chatter going on in the mind. Giving yourself some permission to really tune in to the breath. Really tune into the body, knowing that this space and time you're giving yourself is sacred. And it requires your attention. Moving through your cat and cow here now, just two more times. And just coming to a neutral tabletop position. From here, we'll tuck the toes. And on our next inhale, begin to just gently press back through the heels as we lift the knees up off the mat, hovering here in a lifted tabletop position. So on the next inhale, we'll lift the knees, hovering them just above the ground, an inch or so. Beginning to feel the core turn on here. Beginning to feel the bottoms of the feet, the calves, the hamstrings, the quads, the glutes. Everything beginning to fire here as we hold ourselves steady here for 5, 4, 3, two, and one. Let's lower the knees down, untuck the toes, and let the hips drop behind us, finding our child's pose.
Bringing the forehead closer to the earth, maybe finding a block or a bolster to rest on. Tuning back into that breath. Noticing any new sensations. On your next inhale, we'll lift the chin.
Bring the hands back towards the knees. And from here, I just want you to bring the hands behind the back. Maybe just placing the hands on the hips or finding a clasp. Wherever you can, begin to bring the elbows closer to one another. Beginning to lift the chin and the chest, pulling the shoulders away, opening the chest here. You need a little bit more, you can begin to rise up off the heels, bring the hands further down and lift the chin. And then just exhale, slowly bring the hips towards the heels. We'll sweep the arms up overhead and take a side bend over to the right. If this is a little much on your knees, feel free to stick a block underneath the hips and lift the knees up off underneath the hips and lift the hips up off the ground a little bit higher. Just coming to a comfortable spot that we can take the side bend over to the right. inhaling back to center. And taking a side bend over to the left. Inhale, coming back to center. And as we exhale, we'll mindfully move our hands towards the front of the mat, beginning to tuck the toes and lift the hips, coming into our downward facing dog. Taking a deep breath in through the nose as we pedal through the heels. Deep breaths in and deep breaths out. Finding your center of balance here in this downward facing dog, allowing the beauty of this posture, the simplicity of it, to unfold with you as you take some deep breaths here and allow the body to deepen into this practice. Inhale as we shift forward, finding plank pose, hovering shoulders over wrists and heels over toes. Deep breath in here and exhale, pressing back. Downward facing dog. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Inhale as we shift forward. Heels over toes, shoulders over wrists. Hovering here nice and strong, engaging the quads. And exhale, pressing back, downward facing dog. One more time, inhale, moving forward, finding your plank position. And as you exhale, we'll break the knees, bringing them towards the mat, and finding that hovering position once again. Might need to tiptoe the feet forward. Deep breath in. And exhale, bringing the knees down. Untucking the toes, and again, letting the hips fall towards the heels, finding your child pose. Inhale as you rise back up, finding tabletop. And as you exhale, we'll begin to kick that right heel back behind us, toes pointed down. Working to keep that right hip level, just as high as the left. And keeping everything else stable. From here, let's put a bend into that right knee, flattening the bottom of our feet towards the ceiling. And then we're just gonna pulse here. Just taking 10 pulses with the right knee up. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice job, bringing it back to level. Next, we're gonna take 10 tucks towards the nose. So bringing that right knee in towards the nose, tucking it underneath the body. So on our next exhale, we'll tuck the knee in. Inhale to extend. Exhale to tuck. 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 Two more. Inhale to extend. Exhale to tuck. Last one. Inhale to extend. Exhale to tuck. Holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and exhale, slowly lower that right knee down. From here, let's move into our cat and cow. Just a few breaths. Feeling the length of that breath through the spine. Inhale, coming back to neutral. And exhale, letting it out. Maybe sighing. Maybe being intuitive with the movement here for just a breath or two, shaking it out. From here, we'll begin to extend that left knee long. Pressing through that left heel. And then putting a bend into that left knee, extending the heel towards the ceiling. From here, we're gonna balance out through the other three limbs. And then take 10 pulses of our heel towards the ceiling, lifting that left knee up. So on the next exhale, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Breathing here. 10. Lowering it level. And then on our next natural exhale, we'll tuck that left knee in towards the nose 10 times. So here's 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one. Exhale, hold
for 5, 4, 3, 2. Exhale, lower it down.
From here, we'll just touch the hips back in our child's pose for one breath. Taking the weight out of the wrists, maybe stretching or rolling through those wrists. Then returning to our neutral tabletop position. From here, we'll tuck the toes. Lift the hips up and back, finding our downward facing dog. From here, let's look forward and bend the knees. And as we exhale, slowly walk the feet to the front of the mat. Be mindful of any sleeping puppies taking a nap on your mat. Maybe just give them a nice hug, a little belly rub. Can't be that sleepy, huh? Take an inhale to halfway lift. And an exhale to fold. Inhale, slowly starting to wind your way up, bringing the hands to the sky. Exhale, hands to heart center. Samasthitihi, mountain pose. Tadasana. As we find our mountain pose here, we ground through all four corners of the feet, paying special attention to those insteps. From there, engaging through the calves, pulling the knees upward, engaging the quads, giving a gentle tuck to our hips to elongate the spine, pulling the abdominals in towards the belly button, releasing the shoulders away from the ears, and extending through the crown of the head, feeling strong, connected in this space. We check in with our breath and we check in with our intention. From here, let's reach the arms up towards the sky, lifting our gaze. And as we exhale, we'll sit the hips back towards the heels, finding our chair pose. Maybe hugging the heels and the toes together so that the thighs can support one another. If the low back is a little sore, we can always step the heels out just to hip width. Again, letting the shoulders relax away from the ears, keeping that gaze lifted. The abdominals will be turning on, as will the quads here. Taking a deep breath in, and deep breath out. Nice job, guys. One more deep breath in. On your exhale, sweep the hands forward, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale to halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back. Find your plank pose. Deep breath in here. As you exhale, let's lower down onto the knees. From here, we can squeeze the elbows towards the sides as we lower the chest. Inhaling into our cobra pose, rolling the shoulders back, lifting the chin and the chest, pressing the toes. And exhale, maybe finding your child's pose for just a breath, or maybe just coming straight into your downward facing dog. Three nice deep long breaths here to seal in the work we've done, integrating it into our nervous system, focusing on the breath. Next inhale, let's tiptoe the feet forward as we look towards the front of the mat. Next inhale, halfway lift, bringing the hands to the shins, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold.
Inhale, sweep the arms up to the sky.
Bringing the hands to touch. Take a nice big step out over to the right. We'll take a side bend. Really grounding through that left foot. Opening up that left side body. Inhale to come back to center. And exhale, let's take a side bend over to the left. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Inhale back to center. On our exhale, we'll keep the hands together. Maybe zip the thighs and the heels together. Sit the hips back. Again, finding our chair pose. Practicing tapas, our discipline. As we build fire, remembering to keep the big toes light on the mat, but maybe just hovering slightly. Weight rocking into the heels, shoulders relaxing away from the shoulders. Gaze lifted. For five. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, stand up tall. Maybe taking a gentle back bend here, pulling the shoulders down and away from the ears, squeezing them behind you, lifting the chin and the chest. And exhale, folding forward.
Inhale, halfway lift, Ardha.
Exhale, let's plant the hands, step the feet back. Holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's lower the knees down, squeezing elbows to the sides. We'll again lower for our modified chaturanga. Sweeping the chest forward, rolling the shoulders back for cobra pose. And exhale, let's press back, tucking the toes, downward facing dog. Three nice deep breaths here. Noticing any shifts. Noticing any sensations in the body. Noticing the breath. Let's inhale, shift forward, finding plank pose. As you exhale, let's tag that right knee to the nose. And then exhale, bring that right shin down onto the mat. We'll scooch that left toe back and just lift the chest up from here. From here, we'll tuck the chin. Tuck those left toes. Lift that right knee up. When you lift the body up and exhale, plant that right sole of the foot down. From here, we're gonna walk the hands back, untucking the left toes, finding our half split. Letting those right toes peel up off the earth. That right hip pull back. We press the left hip forward. And then let's reapproach that lunge, bringing both hands inside the right front foot and heel-toeing that right foot off to the right edge of the mat. from here. Any form or variation of this lizard pose is open to you, however you see your body using it. You could stay up on your hands here, even on blocks. You could help guide that right knee open. You could come on down to those forearms. You can even bend that left knee. Reach the toes back, finding the top of the right foot, and giving that left quad a nice stretch. Whatever version of this lizard pose feels comfortable to you, I invite you to take it there. Slowly, without snapping the foot, we'll release those toes down to the ground if they're not there already. We'll heel toe that right foot back to the front, back to the middle of the mat. And then we'll walk the right hand and the left hand up to the top of the right knee, beginning to just stretch into this lunging space. If you're looking for a little more here, you can simply tuck the left toes and lift the left knee up off the mat. Again, finding this lunging space, just a little bit more activity in the balance in the core. Wherever you're at, let's bring the hands down on either side of that right front foot. Tuck the left toes, extend that left knee. And then just begin to straighten that right front knee. So we're coming into like a nice wide pyramid here. You can walk the hands onto some blocks or maybe up that right shin. Deep breaths in. Deep breaths out. Should be feeling a nice stretch through that left calf. As you extend that left heel down towards the mat, keeping both sets of toes pointed forward. Again, energetically drawing that right hip back, pressing that left hip forward, looking for equal distance to the front of the mat. And then from here, let's lift the torso. Just take a baby step forward with that left foot. And then we'll reapproach our triangle pose from a little bit of a shorter stance. So from here, let's lift the chin and the chest, maybe bringing the hands to the hips, or perhaps finding a clasp or a hold behind the back. And just gently exhale, folding forward over this right front foot. Taking it nice and slow, moving with the breath, and then bringing the hands down. Whenever you feel ready, gently untucking the chin, gently releasing the neck, letting the head hang heavy here, releasing any tension in the shoulders. Deep breaths in, deep breaths out. Inhale, looking forward, taking one more step forward, that left foot, meeting the right foot at the front of the mat, take an inhale to halfway lift, and an exhale to fold. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale, we'll plant the hands, step the feet back. And again, find our plank pose. Deep breath in here and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna slowly lower down, maybe using your chaturanga this time, or maybe coming down to the knees like we have before. Inhaling to up dog or cobra. And exhaling, finding your downward facing dog. Taking a nice deep exhale on this down dog, and then taking three more nice deep breaths when you find this space. Inhale as you shift forward, finding plank pose. Exhale, we'll bring that left knee down. And then just begin to sit back on that left heel. Maybe untucking those right toes. Lifting the chin and the chest. Beginning to look down towards the mat once again. We'll tuck the right toes, lift up and pull that left knee into the chest. Exhale as we plant that left foot down onto the mat. Nice job. From here, we can lower onto that right knee, untuck the right toes, and begin to extend that left leg long. Maybe those left toes coming up off the mat. Finding our half split, or wherever you're at, your version of split here. Deep breath in through the nose and out through the nose. From here, we'll walk the fingertips forward, coming to the inside of that left front foot. We'll heel toe that left foot off to the edge of the mat, carefully just missing your doggy's ear. And then from here, in this lizard lunge, you can find your variation. So maybe coming down onto the forearms, or perhaps staying up on the hands, maybe helping to guide that left knee open, or perhaps even reaching back, bending at the right knee, and finding the right toes with the left hand. Wherever you're at, just remembering to breathe deeply. Untucking those right toes, maybe letting them release gently to the mat. And then heel toeing that left foot back to the center. We'll bring the left hand to the outside of the left foot. And from here, we're just going to tuck the right toes under, straighten that right knee, and then straighten that left knee, coming into a nice wide pyramid pose. Working with hip alignment here, we want to press that right hip forward, pull that left hip back. Yes, it's going to become more intense in that left hamstring. That's okay. That right heel may pop up off the mat, and that's okay too. Just working to keep both legs active. Pressing. Noticing the breath. your next exhale, we're gonna just hop that right foot forward about a foot and a half or maybe two. And then let the hips resettle back again, pressing the right forward, pulling the left back. And settle in here for our pyramid pose. So here we want to release any tension in the shoulders and in the neck, letting the head just hang heavy. Maybe observing some gentle bends in the knees here. Allowing the chest to come down and try to rest on that left thigh. Take an inhale here, looking forward. And as you exhale, let's step that right foot to the front of the mat, meeting the left. Inhale to halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, let's sweep the arms all the way up to the sky, standing tall. Lifting the chin. And exhale, hands to heart center, Samasthitihi, mountain pose. Deep breaths in. Deep breaths out. From here, we'll bring the hands to the back of the hips, working to squeeze those elbows behind us. From here, we're going to lift the chin, pull the shoulders down and away from the ears as we open the chest and find a gentle back bend here, pressing the hips forward. You kind of find your balance tested, just keep at it. And now slowly starting to rise back up. Notice it's harder to breathe and talk in these poses. That's okay, just focus on the breath. And as you exhale, we're going to bend forward, Uttanasana, forward fold, nice and slow. Bringing the hands down to the earth, letting the head hang heavy. Inhale to halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step the feet back. Again, we'll find our plank pose. Deep breath in here. Exhale, lower the knees down, untuck the toes, squeeze elbows to the sides, lowering through chaturanga. Inhale to cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Maybe touching a child's pose on your way there. Taking three nice deep breaths here. Inhale as you shift forward. Finding plank pose. Exhale, bringing the knees down to the mat. We'll cross the ankles and roll down onto the hips. Extending the legs forward. And again, really finding those sits bones, moving the fleshy part of the bum away, really rooting yourself in here. We'll bring the hands down by the sides, pull the shoulders away from the ears, open the chest. Elongate through the spine, keeping both feet active. And then as we exhale, we'll fold forward nice and slow, finding our Paschimottanasana. Taking our time here, we want to keep a gentle bend in the knees. We want to keep extending the chest as far forward as we can before rounding through the neck and the shoulders. So just working to keep the chest pulling forward here, bit by bit by bit, breath by breath. And when you feel you've gone as far as you want to go, I invite you to just gently tuck the chin down, round through the shoulders. Feel the length of the spine. We'll be here for 5 more breaths, so take your time. Inhale, slowly starting to round yourself up. And as we exhale, we'll begin to shift the hips forward, reclining down onto the back. You can hug the knees into the chest and just kind of roll rounding through the spine, maybe rocking from side to side here. Sending heels up towards the sky, bringing the hands to the back of the quads here, to the hamstrings. Just press through the heels and extend those legs long, maybe pointing through the toes and flexing through the heels, perhaps rolling those ankles around. You exhale, bring the heels down towards the earth, pressing them into the mat, extending the arms by the sides, palms facing down. Once you feel all 4 corners of those feet grounded, we will engage through those inner thighs and then begin to lift the hips up off the earth, finding our bridge pose. Keeping both feet grounded, all 4 corners, and really pressing through the heels, through the shoulders to find our length here in the spine. Squeezing through those inner thighs. Exhale as you tap the hips down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, tap. Inhale to lift. Exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. Exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. Exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. Exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. One more. Exhale, tap. Inhale, lift. Really squeezing through those inner thighs. We'll hold for 5, 4, 3, 2. Exhale, slowly roll the back down. Bringing the soles of the feet together, let's let the knees tip out wide, finding our Supta Baddha Konasana. bound angle pose. Maybe bringing the hands to the tops of the thighs here and just helping to guide those knees apart. That's a little too much pressure for you. You can just bring the right hand to the chest and the left hand to the belly, feeling the breath. If you need a little bit more support, you can always pop a block or two underneath the knees so that you can fully relax into this pose, feeling supported. Inhale, starting to tip the knees up, finding the soles of the feet on the ground. And exhale, we'll begin to tip the knees over to the left side as we cactus the arms and take your gaze over to the right. We're going to keep both shoulders grounded, letting the twist come from the soft belly here. Inhale back to center. And exhale, knees over to the right side. Gazing over towards the left shoulder. Inhale, bringing the knees back to center. And as you exhale, just begin to straighten the legs down. Maybe keeping watch of the dog at the bottom of your mat. Bringing the hands down by the sides, turning the palms open to the sky. Allowing a state of pure release, pure bliss, pure contentment. Take over. As we open up to a state of gratitude for all the many parts of this practice that have captivated us, that have drawn us in. Extending gratitude to ourselves for bringing ourselves to this practice and investing in our wellness, our healing.